In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software, Infinite Algebra 1, Free Worksheet, Radical Equations, Part 2, also known as Radical Equations Hard. Our directions for this worksheet are to solve each equation and remember to check for extraneous solutions. This is very important, and I'll show you why in number 1. So in number 1, in order to solve for n, I'm going to square each side. So I'll get 110 minus n equal to n squared. Now I'm going to move my n squared to the same side so that I have it equal to 0 and therefore have a quadratic. So I'll have negative n squared plus 110 minus n equal to 0. However, I don't want my n squared to be negative, so I'm going to multiply everything by negative 1. So multiplying the left by negative 1 and the right by negative 1. So I'll get n squared plus a negative 110 or minus 110 plus n equals 0 times negative 1, which is 0. Now I'm just going to rewrite this in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. So I'll have n squared plus n minus 110. That's equal to 0. So now, number 1, I'll be able to factor. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 110, and that's a negative 110, and add to give me 1. Well, I know those numbers for 110 will be 11 and 10, where the 11 is positive since this is a positive n, so the 10 will be negative. Negative 10 times 11 is negative 110. So I'll have n plus 11 times n minus 10 equal to 0. So remember, I need to see when n plus 11 equals 0 and when n minus 10 equals 0. N plus 11 equals 0 when n is equal to negative 11, because negative 11 plus 11 equals 0. N minus 10 equals 0 when n is equal to a positive 10, because 10 minus 10 is 0. So you see I have two solutions, negative 11 and 10. But remember that important note was to check for extraneous solutions. So let's look back at our original equation. Our original equation was the square root of 110 minus n equals n. And remember, taking a square root is not going to give us a negative number. Therefore, n cannot be negative. So n cannot be negative 11, because taking the square root of 110 minus n cannot be negative. Therefore, our solution in number 1 is just 10. So writing this in set notation, 10 is our only solution. Let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, we're going to start the same way we started in number 1. We're going to square both sides. So we'll have p squared equal to 2 minus p, because the square root of 2 minus p squared is 2 minus p. So then I'm going to subtract 2 and add p to both sides. And I'll do that so that I'm left with 0 on my right-hand side. So I'll have p squared plus p minus 2 equal to 0. Now I'll be able to factor p squared plus p minus 2. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me a negative 2 but add to give me a positive 1. So the factors of 2 that multiply to give you 2 are 1 and 2, and add to give you a positive 1 when that 2 is negative, we'll use negative 1. Negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, and negative 1 plus 2 is a positive 1. So we'll have p minus 1 times p plus 2. That's equal to 0. So we need to see when p minus 1 equals 0 and when p plus 2 equals 0. Because if either of those are 0, 0 times any quantity equals 0, and vice versa. Any quantity times 0 equals 0. So p minus 1 equals 0 when p is a positive 1. P plus 2 equals 0 when p is a negative 2. However, remembering our original equation, it was p equals the square root of 2 minus p. And remember, the square root of a number will not give you a negative number. So p cannot equal negative 2, even though when we factored and found that solution, it is not true for our original equation. It is an extraneous solution. Therefore, P equals 1 is our solution. So 1 is our answer in number 2. In number 3, when I square both sides, I'll get 30 minus x equals x squared. So what I'm going to do, I'll subtract 30 from both sides, and I'll also add x to both sides. So I'll get 0 equal to x squared plus x minus 30. So I'm in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. My 0 is just on the left-hand side. So if you want to, just flip this around and write it as x squared plus x minus 30 equals 0 if you feel more comfortable that way. Now, we need to factor x squared plus x minus 30. So what two numbers multiply to give me negative 30 and add to give me positive 1? That's going to be 5 and 6, but because that x is positive, my 5 will be the factor that's negative. So we'll have x minus 5 times x plus 6 equal to 0. So I'm going to see when x minus 5 equals 0 and when x plus 6 equals 0. X minus 5 equals 0 when x is equal to a positive 5, because 5 minus 5 is 0. X plus 6 equals 0 when x is equal to a negative 6, because negative 6 plus 6 equals 0. So one easy way to remember is just taking the opposite sign of whatever your variable is added to. And this is true for the case when your coefficient of your variable is 1. So because we have x minus 5, I know that a positive 5 will make that 0. And because we have x plus 6, I know that a negative 6 will make that 0. And again, that's true when your coefficient of your variable x is 1. So we have x equal to 5 and x equal to negative 6. However, if you remember from our original equation, the square root of a quantity cannot be negative. Therefore, x cannot equal negative 6. So for number 3, x is equal to 5 is our only solution. So 5 is the answer in number 3. For number 4, we're going to start by squaring both sides. So I'll have x squared equal to 8x, because the square root of 8x squared is 8x. Now I'll subtract 8x from both sides. So we'll have x squared minus 8x equal to 0. So all I need to do is pull out an x from each of these terms. So x squared minus 8x factored is x times x minus 8, and that's equal to 0. So this equation's true when x equals 0 and when x minus 8 equals 0. So again, that's when x equals 0 or when x minus 8 equals 0, which will be x equal to a positive 8, because 8 minus 8 equals 0. So you can see in number 4, again, I come with two solutions. However, let's double check for extraneous solutions. Well, what makes this problem different is that we started with x equal to the square root of 8x. And remember, we cannot have a negative number equal to the square root of some quantity. However, x equals 0 and x equals 8, neither of those are negative. And if you double check plugging 0 in for x, the equation holds true. And plugging 8 in for x, the equation also holds true. So in number 4, I have two solutions, 0 and 8. In number 5, I'm going to start by squaring both sides. So I'll have x squared equal to the square root of 42 minus x squared, which is 42 minus x. So I'm going to be subtracting 42 from both sides. And at the same time, I'm also going to be adding x to both sides. In doing this, my 42 and my x will cancel out on my right-hand side. So I'll have x squared plus x minus 42 equal to 0. So I'll be able to factor that quadratic. I need to figure out what two numbers multiply to give me negative 42 and add to give me a positive 1. I know that 6 times 7 is equal to 42. However, if this 42 is negative, but my 1 is positive, that's going to be negative 6 times 7. So I'll have x minus 6 times x plus 7 equal to 0. So I need to see for what values of x will x minus 6 equal 0 and x plus 7 equal 0. So for x minus 6 equal to 0, that's when x is equal to a positive 6. And for x plus 7 equal to 0, x will be equal to a negative 7. But again, I cannot have a negative number equal to the square root of some quantity. Therefore, I cannot have x equal to negative 7. So x equals 6 is my solution in number 5. In number 6, again, I'll square both sides in order to get rid of that radical. So I'll have 12 minus r equal to r squared. So what I'll do, I'll just subtract by r squared. So I'll have negative r squared, and then I'll subtract r, and then add my 12, just switching up this order, and that's going to be equal to 0. However, I don't want my r squared to be negative in order to factor, so I'll multiply by negative 1. So I'll have a positive r squared plus a positive r minus 12 equal to 0. Now I'll factor. I need to find two numbers that multiply to give me 12, and that's a negative 12, but add to give me a positive 1. And that's going to be 4 and 3, where the 4 is positive. So r plus 4 times r minus 3 equals 0. So I need to see when r plus 4 equals 0 and when r minus 3 equals 0. And that occurs when r is equal to negative 4, because negative 4 plus 4 equals 0. And it also occurs when r is equal to positive 3, because 3 minus 3 equals 0. However, looking back at our original equation, we have the square root of 12 minus r equal to r. So the square root of that 12 minus r cannot equal a negative number. Therefore, r equals negative 4 is not a solution. So our only solution in number 6 is r equals a positive 3. And lastly, in this video, we'll go over number 7. In number 7, I'll start by squaring both sides. So I'll get that the square root of 4n squared is 4n, and that's equal to n squared. So I'll subtract n squared from both sides. So I'll have 4n minus n squared equal to 0, because n squared minus n squared is 0. Now I'll be able to pull out n from each of these terms, since 4 is multiplied by n, and n times n is n squared. So pulling out an n, I'll get 4 minus n within those parentheses, and that's equal to 0. So n times 4 minus n is 4n minus n squared. So that means I need to see when n equals 0 and when 4 minus n equals 0, because 0 times any quantity is 0. And if you're confused on factoring, refer back to one of my previous worksheets where I explain the process more in depth and go through each step with more detail. So I'll leave a link in the description below to one of those previous CUDA software website worksheets. But continuing on with this problem, n equals 0 is one possible solution, and 4 minus n equals 0, that will be n equal to a positive 4, because 4 minus 4 equals 0. Now because 0 and 4 are non-negative, I'll have two solutions for number 7, 0 and 4. And if you want to double check, plug in 0 and then plug in 4 to see that you will indeed get that the square root of 4 times n equals n. I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll finish the first page of this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.